The phase stability principle is most comprehensively implemented in, of course, such accelerators as synchrotrons. The principle of operation of a synchrotron itself was suggested by a UK scientist, Marcus Oliphant, in 1943. The essence of the operation of this accelerator lies in the fact that a charged particle beam is constrained to move in a constant circle radius. In doing so, a tiny vacuum chamber can be made, as well as a relatively compact magnetic system. Such a structure, in fact, allows us to increase the energy of accelerated particles almost infinitely, to the extent of the Earth's size. Theoretical frameworks of such accelerators were actually outlined in Wechsler's phase stability principle. And when Marcus Oliphant got acquainted with the works of Wechsler, he said, "Yes, now I understand why this accelerator should indeed work." He always acknowledged Wechsler's precedence at the creation of this accelerator type. The first large facilities, namely synchrotrons, built with the use of phase stability principle, with the cosmotron at the Brookhaven National Laboratory and the bevatron at the Lawrence Berkeley National Laboratory, both located in the US. The cosmotron at Brookhaven accelerated protons up to the energy of 3 giga electron volts. In 1952, it was put into operation. In 1954, a large synchrotron known as the bevatron was constructed at Berkeley. The energy of accelerated protons reached 6 giga electron volts. The bevatron was built for a particular task of physics, the discovery of the antiproton. It became operational in 1954. These accelerators use the so-called weak focusing principle, where both the turn and the focusing of particles is done with the use of a magnet with an azimuthally symmetric magnetic field. This is the reason that led to the large size of the vacuum chamber. For example, the bevatron had a beam vacuum chamber of more than 4 meters horizontally and 1.2 meters vertically. These were massive magnets. Later on, a few other weak focusing synchrotrons were built. Among the famous ones are the weak-focusing synchrotrons in Argonne, the Saturn in France, and the Nimrod in the UK. But the most well-known facility of such a class is the synchrophasotron in Dubna, which was built and became operational in 1957. Its perimeter is 210 meters. It used to accelerate protons up to an energy range of 10 giga electron volts, which was a record at the time. This accelerator made history. Its launch was perceived by mankind in the same manner as the first satellite mission. Both events took place in the same year. The front pages of all the world's newspapers reported on this event. This accelerator was called the Pyramid of the 20th Century. Its magnet is still the largest electromagnet ever built by people throughout history. Its weight is 36,000 tons. For this characteristic, the magnet has been added to the Guinness Book of Records.